Good morning, viewers. Welcome to Focal Point on Urban TV. It's a new year, 2017. I trust you'll have a prosperous 2017. Today we are discussing a very interesting topic. Bessie calls for dialogue. Has the defiance campaign come to an end? And to help me do that, I have distinguished individuals in the studio, and I will introduce them in turn, but not in any order of priority. I have in the studio Moses Mulondo, a New Vision Group journalist who covers political matters. Welcome to Focal Point.
Thank you very much.
I also have Duncan Abigaba, the Deputy Special Presidential Assistant. Duncan, welcome and compliments.
Thank you, Elton, and good morning, our dear viewers.
I have Madame Ingrid Turinawe, the Secretary for Mobilization and Organization in the Forum for Democratic Change. Madame Ingrid, welcome to Focal Point.
Thank you so much for hosting me. Good morning, viewers. Happy New Year to everybody. I greet you all in the spirit of one Uganda, one people.
Wonderful. So the news has been awash with calls that Dr. Besigye is calling for dialogue. But before we go into the crux of the matter and discuss and dissect this issue, would like to play a clip. Just watch.
Former presidential candidate Dr. Kizza Besigye has previously turned down several individuals and groups trying to organize talks between the opposition and President Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, saying the terms of the meeting must first be mutually agreed upon. Speaking to press yesterday, Besigye spelled out some of the conditions he wants to be considered before the talks between him and Museveni take place.
These kind of situations cannot be just wished away by having a chat over a table. There must be a properly structured process. And that is why we have been talking about agreeing on a mutual facilitator that starts the process, not either Besigye inviting Museveni or Museveni inviting Besigye or a church leader inviting these people. There must be a process of agreeing on a mutual facilitator. That's important. Who is respected by all? Two, you must consider what mechanisms will guarantee the implementation of what you agree.
I want to break ice by asking Madame Ingrid. Madame Ingrid, from 2011, Dr. Besigye has been calling for a defiance campaign in what he termed a rigged election. There is possibility that he's calling for dialogue now. Why do you want to talk now? Has the defiance campaign ended? Has it failed?
Thank you so much. First of all, I want to disagree with the topic of the program this morning. The topic which reads that Dr. Besigye calls for dialogue. First of all, that is not true. The correct topic would have been Dr. Besigye welcomes dialogue. Because clearly Dr. Besigye has never set out to call for dialogue. The person who is calling for dialogue and he is desperately calling for dialogue is known, and that is Mr. Museveni. He has sent teams, he has sent messages, he has sent people, and I wouldn't be willing to mention names, but they know themselves. So the latest being the women in situation, the situation room women. They have been contacting us as FDC and contacting Dr. Besigye as an individual, being sent by Mr. Museveni for dialogue. So clearly I want to say that Dr. Besigye welcomes dialogue, but he's not calling for dialogue. The person who is calling for dialogue is Mr. Museveni. And that's why Dr. Besigye came out very clearly to set out conditions for the dialogue. It must not be like a wedding meeting. It must not be just a friendly meeting. We must all agree that a dialogue is for Ugandans, not for any individual, not for any groups. It's for Ugandans. That's why Dr. Besigye says there must be a convener who must be agreed upon by the parties. You cannot just sit after everything that he has done in the 30 years to Ugandans, and you say you come for a dialogue. Is what Dr. Besigye has been rejecting. He has never rejected to participate in the dialogue, and he has never called for a dialogue. Mr. Museveni has called for a dialogue, and Dr. Besigye is giving conditions. There must be a neutral convener, right, who is agreed upon by the parties. There must be a clear agenda that is agreed by the by everybody. You shouldn't call me for any meeting without knowing what we are going to discuss.
Okay.
So there must be an agenda that benefits our country, that benefits our people and our future. And there must be the implementation process. What if we go for the talks and then we agree on certain decisions, we resolve on certain decisions, then what
happens
next
after?
Who implements? Those are the conditions he's giving. The moment these conditions are fulfilled, then he will come dialogue. But the moment they are not fulfilled, then he will not be part of that. He can't be part of a tea meeting.
Okay, we'll come
but
back
then,
to those
now,
those
now
issues.
Before I leave, I'm still talking about the topic.
Right.
This other sentence on the screen that as the defiance campaign comes to an end, let me tell you, defiance campaign has just started. And if you can give me a chance, I will tell Ugandans what the defiance campaign is, what it is doing, and how it is going to be implemented. The defiance campaign cannot come to an end before it starts.
Moses came up with an article recently, and it's, are you being proved wrong factually? Because you're saying Museveni, Dr. Besigye calls for dialogue. What do you have to say so that we agree on the topic as we go in and dive into this?
Mm-hmm. You know, first of all, I attended that press conference, and there were so many other journalists from different media houses. And we all captured the same angle that Dr. Kizza Besigye has called for dialogue.
Yeah.
But of course, it remains the same topic. Whether you want to take the perspective of Besigye calling for dialogue or welcoming dialogue, the essence, the gist of the matter is that there is need for dialogue in this country. And I think that is where the debate should be. And this debate should not, of course, again, be personalized. It should not be Besigye Museveni. It should be a national dialogue. And as a journalist, I have been following these discussions from different stakeholders, even from the religious leaders. They have been calling for a national dialogue that involves different stakeholders, including cultural institutions. I remember in the Lancaster conference before we got independence, cultural institutions were very key in those talks. So, but of course, you see, dialogue is about consensus building. Mm-hmm. When you look at our political parties, even the opposition, before the opposition gets into talks with DNLM,
yes,
is there consensus building in the opposition? It's not there, even within FDC. Because I understand it, even that very press conference where Besigye was talking, the communication he made, I don't think there was consensus building before. I don't think he met the different stakeholders within the opposition or within FDC and they agreed that this is the way forward. You go and announce, because in that press conference he announced, he declared the people's government, where Madam Ingrid, I think, is one of the ministers.
Internal affairs.
Minister for Internal Affairs. Mm. But again, some FDC leaders, I saw some Jew, Nganda, Nabil, and others saying that we are not part of that. You will clarify on that. I may not have gotten them well.
Yep.
But I understand there are so many FDC leaders who are opposed to that declaration of a people's government. So that is why it makes it very complicated, by the way, this consensus building. Because even before going into consensus building with the NRM, the opposition has failed to build the consensus. You know what happened during TDA? The Democratic Alliance.
Yes.
And there has not been any change in any part of the world in a situation like what is prevailing in Uganda without an alliance. So of course that is the only way, if the opposition wants to get into power or to be strong, that is the only way they can get there. But during TDA, these leaders made commitments that, and they even signed those commitments and said, if I am entering into this arrangement and I will accept the candidate who will be chosen by the majority. And I understand they had almost chosen Amama Mbabazi to be the flag bearer for TDA, and some few leaders of FDC came and stormed into the meeting and took away Dr. Kizza Besigye. But also Dr. Kizza Besigye as a leader, I would blame him because he had already made a commitment that I will accept the decision that will be made by the majority, and the majority had chosen Amama Mbabazi to be the alliance candidate. And Dr. Kizza Besigye actually turned against the commitment he had
that has been made.
So dialogue is about consensus building, and me, I have been telling people objectively that Dr. Kizza Besigye's greatest failure that keeps the opposition weak is the failure to unite the opposition in Uganda. Because he has been the face of the opposition for so long, but he has failed to unite the opposition. Maybe he has made attempts, and there are other factors why he has not succeeded. Madam Ingrid Runai will clarify on that. But the truth is there is need for dialogue in our country, because if dialogue is not given a chance, then people resort to other means, like violence, like some people can resort going to armed struggle, which can be very dangerous. Our economy right now is very fragile. If Besigye resumed those street protests like Walk to Work, I think it can greatly affect our economy. I remember in 2011, 2012, when they were carrying out those protests, so many tourists were scared away from coming to Uganda. The number of tourists coming to Uganda dropped. Even many investors were scared away from coming to Uganda. So all of them need this dialogue. The government, the NRM needs dialogue, but also the opposition needs dialogue, because there is no way you can have the reforms that you want to have. We saw in Kenya, Raila Odinga meeting Uhuru, and they agreed on the way forward, even here. And I don't think it is also good to put so many conditions. You give it a benefit.
All right, we'll come back.
Meet them.
I want to hear from Duncan. Duncan, you are in the sitting government right now, and the calls for dialogue. Madam Ingrid just said President Museveni has been calling for a conversation with Dr. Besigye. What is your perspective on this matter?
Dialogue. Today, I think Madam Ingrid has told the news to the nation that the president has been calling for dialogue, because it's something I'm hearing for the first time, to be sincere. And the president has been clear, even in the past, during one of his press conferences in campaigns. You know, I think one of the journalists provoked him on the issue of dialogue and a coalition government, and he dismissed that. He said he can never partake in a coalition government. And I think what the FDC dialogue, what they are proposing and projecting is something of the sort.
But don't you think there are issues that, are you willing to hear them out? Because I think there are issues. They are defying, because I believe that there are issues that they need heard, that they need tabled. Are you guys in the government agreed that yes, we need to talk to these people, or that avenue is shut out?
No, I don't think it's shut out. But
I want to disagree.
The objective has to be clear.
He's misrepresenting.
You will respond.
It's okay. The objectives are not clear yet, in my opinion. Because the message says a dialogue can only happen if they are talking about transition. And we all know that the means of transiting power in this country are not through dialogue and discussion. They are through the ballot.
True. Right.
So transition can only happen through the ballot. That one is very clear. And I don't think government will participate in such a dialogue where they are discussing their own exit.
Sure. Okay. Allow me, you will pick this up after the break. Allow us to take a short break. And when we return, we want to keep talking about this issue, the issue of dialogue, the issue of consensus. What are the issues? What is the bone of contention? Please feel free to follow us on Facebook, Urban Television, on Twitter, @UrbanTV Uganda. Don't go away. We will be right back.